Good evening and welcome to another episode of the Artist Showcase. I'm your host Shannon Rae, and tonight we're featuring two sets of siblings who are living their dreams in television, film, commercials, and on the stage. We're here at the CEC TV studio on campus at Utah Tech University in Southern Utah, and we'll introduce you to these up-and-coming stars right after this. Welcome back. I'm here with young artists Charlie Stover and Harper Griffith. Charlie has been featured in Variety and Deadline magazines, played the role of young Spencer Dutton in the drama television series Yellowstone, and has walked the infamous red carpet at the Cannes Film Festival in France. Harper has performed extensively on the stage as well as film, television, and commercials, and they are here with us tonight to tell us all about it. Hello, you two.
Hi, thanks for having us.
Yes, you're welcome. I'm so happy to have you here.
Yes.
And I would like to mention the Sugar Cookie. They are one of our sponsors tonight. They've provided these beautiful sugar cookies in honor of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory that both of you are performing in right now at TuaCon.
Uh-huh. Yes.
So we would like to thank them. Yes. So, you two have been friends for a while. You've performed in, I think, 4 seasons at TuaCon together. Is that right?
Yes. Yeah.
And Harper? You've been on the Artist Showcase, so we're going to be catching up with you. Charlie, this is your first time in the Artist Showcase.
Yeah.
We're happy to have you.
Yes, thank you.
You're welcome. How old are both of you?
I'm 13 years old.
I'm 11.
Okay, that's wonderful. So, Charlie, I'd like to start with you.
Yeah.
You are the little brother of Lily Mae, and we'll get to meet her later.
Yes.
And this is a show with two sets of siblings, so we'll get to meet Lily Mae. You have performed quite a bit at TuaCon, and you've had some really fun roles.
Yes, I have.
Could you tell us about which roles you played?
Yes, yeah, so my first role at TuaCon was in the Haven Theater, Elf the Musical, where I was in the kid ensemble, but I was understudy for Michael Hobbs. And then my first summer season was Chip in Beauty and the Beast and School of Rock. I was James understudy for Billy, and yeah.
That's so fun. I saw that show. Yeah. I thought you were amazing. Okay, and then you're also playing this season.
Yeah, and last year I was in Mary Poppins, and I played Michael Banks.
That's right. Yes, and we had Gail Bennett
and
Lydia on the show.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So tell us what you're doing now at TuaCon.
So right now I'm in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, where I'm playing Charlie Bucket.
Oh, that's incredible.
Yes.
And how do you remember the moment you found out that you were going to be playing that part?
I was at a dance competition with my school, and we were practicing the dance because we had like 10 more minutes before we went on to perform. Mm-hmm. And then once we were done practicing in just like the hallway, my mom called me over because Sherry was on the phone, and she told me I had the role.
How did that feel?
It was really good, and then we got second place in the dance competition.
Oh, what a great day. That's incredible. So of all of those roles, those are really fun, great roles.
Mm-hmm.
What was the most memorable for you? I mean, you've finished rehearsals and you've started performing with Charlie this year.
This role is extra special because it's like the lead role and the name of the show, mm-hmm. but also it's my name in real life.
No.
Yeah, but mm-hmm. this role has been really fun. But School of Rock was like really fun too, because I had all the kids. My sister and her sister mm-hmm. was in it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was fun.
Okay, you also had 2 callbacks for The Music Man on Broadway.
Yes.
So will you tell us about what happened with that?
Yeah, so my mom got called, I think like a week maybe before, a couple days before, and then we had to like get COVID tested a bunch because it was during COVID. Oh. And I had to miss a couple shows at TuaCon because I had to fly out and audition. And then the first time I made it through all the way, but then I didn't get the role. And then the second time, like 7 months later, I went back and I didn't get the role again.
That's okay. You never know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
And you've had a lot of really amazing opportunities. Just a really good
experience.
It was
a really good experience, yes.
You've also done film and television. So film, you've been in a couple of movies. You were in one with your sister.
Yeah, I did one with my sister last summer, This Bloody Country. It was filmed up in Kanab, and that was, I think, a couple weeks. And yeah, it was fun.
Was that kind of a different role for you to play?
Not really, because it's kind of, it was like a western-y kind of, and I've done those roles before, so it was kind of the same.
Where have you done that? Yellowstone?
I was in Yellowstone, and I filmed it in Montana.
Which part did you play in Yellowstone?
I was young Spencer Dutton. It was a flashback scene, and it was like kind of 1884. It was like in Yellowstone, but it was about 1884, because they made a sequel after it.
And did you get to know Kevin Costner very well?
No, I didn't meet him, but during School of Rock, he came and saw the show, and then he wanted to meet me, so so we kind of like met.
That's really nice that he wanted to meet you. You've had the most incredible experience. Mm-hmm. I know you just returned from France.
From France, yes.
And why were you in France?
So the movie that I filmed 2 summers ago was filmed by Rustin Razzouli called The Riddle of Fire. And that was fun because it was about like 3 kids who rode dirt bikes and like just got into mischief. My name was Hazel. And I had a little brother named Jody and then our friend Alice. And then later on the way we met this girl named Petal.
Petal. Yes. So you filmed 2 years ago.
Yeah.
But you recently returned from France. What were you doing in France?
Yeah. So the movie got accepted. It was accepted into another film festival in this country. Mm-hmm. But then we got into Cannes Film Festival, which is like the biggest one in the world.
I know.
So we obviously went to that one. And they flew the kids out. And so we had a couple, like the first 2 days we didn't have anything, but then the next day we had like press and stuff, and then we had the red carpet, and then we had the premiere, which was really awesome to see the movie. We had lots of press and pictures and stuff.
And then the red carpet.
The red carpet was really, really fun. You would walk a couple steps, turn, and they would take pictures, turn, take pictures. Then we would walk, do it again, walk up the stairs. Then there'd be this like huge camera that like flew in. But yeah.
Not many people get to do that.
I know.
Did you feel like a superstar?
Yeah, it felt like, it was really weird because it felt like amazing. It felt really cool.
I bet.
Yeah.
I'm so excited for you. That's amazing. What's coming up for you? You're pursuing dance and singing, and what are you doing next?
I'm just, after this season, I don't really know. I'm hoping to, I want to get a show out in New York or like Chicago or something. So I'd love to play like Billy Elliot but I just have school after this, going into 8th grade. Have VRS, which is like the MDT company. It's like the highest one. And then Principal Dance Company, which is the highest dance company that we have at school.
Okay, what are you singing for us tonight?
Tonight I'll be singing a short clip of Willy Wonka, Willy Wonka from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. And then I'll be singing Electricity from Billy Elliot. And then me and Harper are singing A Million Dreams from The Greatest Showman.
Before we cut to commercial, tell us really quickly what it's like performing at Tuacon as Charlie right now. What is a day like for you on a day that you perform?
So yeah, I don't really have anything during the day, but when I get in at night, I have to go and do flight call, which is like, because I fly in the show, it's really fun. And then I have to get my mic, put my clothes on, and then we go to places, all the kids, because they're in the first number. I have to get my satchel, and then I get in the table, and then they roll me on. I'm basically on the show, or on the stage the whole show. And then at the very end, I do a quick change into a Willy Wonka costume. And yeah, it's basically just like a whole night on stage. which is really fun.
I've already seen it, and I mm-hmm. would like to see it 10 more times. It is such a fun show.
Yeah, it's really fun.
And this was kind of you last year when you were playing Chloe mm-hmm. and yeah. Alice in Wonderland.
Yeah.
So you both have kind of experienced the schedule. You're both probably really tired.
I mean, yeah, but like,
you perform tonight.
Since we don't really have anything during the day, we can sleep in longer and
That's
stuff.
Good.
So yeah, it's good.
Well, we're excited to hear you sing.
Thank you.
You can find Charlie on Instagram at Charlie S. Stover and on his IMDb variety page for his credits. Charlie will be taking the stage right after this.
Come with me and you'll be in a world of pure imagination.
My name is Willy Wonka. I make chocolate. Who can take a sunrise? Sprinkle it with dew.
Willy Wonka's the greatest chocolatier who ever lived.
Cover it in chocolate and a miracle or two, the Candyman can.
Wonka?
Factory. To open?
At last! Inside some of the many chocolate bars, he has hidden 5 golden tickets!
I can't afford chocolate, sir. I only get 1 bar a year on my birthday.
What'd you say your name was again?
Bucket, sir. Charlie Bucket.
Wonka mania is sweeping the world.
Nobody could want a ticket more than me.
Like my Mutter und my Vasa, I enjoy a healthy meal. Yes, my outside's soft and flabby, but my inside's made of steel.
Charming child. Quite the gastronome, eh, Bucket?
My Veruca expressed a very keen interest in the contest. She said,
I want the tickets now!
How could I possibly refuse?
Whole countries are torn apart as warring factions scramble for Wonka bars.
Bow down to the Queen of Funk! Queen of Funk!
My daddy says that it's my time.
And there ain't no doubt about it.
Yes, you love that class in the Queen of Funk!
I got my golden ticket the American way. I hacked Willy Wonka, that's how I won. You gotta break rules to get the job done. Mine, mine, mine!
It's coming!
One day this will all make a great story.
I've got a golden ticket. I've got a golden twinkle in my eye.
Yours are the first eyes to ever see it. A world made completely and entirely out of candy.
There is no life I know to compare with pure imagination.
Come on, Charlie!
And there you'll be free if you truly wish to be.
Hi, my name is Charlie Stover, and I'll be singing Willy Wonka, Willy Wonka from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
And so it's been decades, and Wonka's grown old, like I told you. It's like he was dead. Then I saw the shop, and then lo and behold, the explosion you heard was my head. Willy Wonka, Willy Wonka, oh, the joy since I've learned his chocolate's returned. Now I'm wishing to someday be able to buy one bar.
Thank you. And now I'll be singing Electricity from Billy Elliot.
You can't control. I suppose it's like forgetting, losing who you are, but at the same time, something makes you whole. It's like that there's music playing in your ear, but the music is impossible, impossible to hear, and then I feel it move me.
like a burning deep inside. Something burst in me, wide open, impossible to hide. And suddenly I'm flying, flying like a bird, like electricity. Electricity sparks inside of me. It's a bit like being angry. It's a bit like being scared, confused and all mixed up, and that is hell. It's like when you've been crying and you're empty and you're full. I don't know what it is, it's hard to tell. It's like that there's music playing in your ear, and I'm listening, and I'm listening, and then I disappear, and then I feel a change, like a fire deep inside. Something burst in me, wide open, impossible to hide. And suddenly I'm flying, flying like a bird, like electricity. Electricity sparks inside of me, and I'm free, I'm free, free, I'm free.
Thank you. Now I'd like to invite Harper onto the stage, and we will be singing A Million Dreams from The Greatest Showman. I close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care if they call me crazy. A world that we design. 'Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me awake. I think of what the world could be, a vision of the one I see. A million dreams is all it's gonna take. Oh, a million dreams for the world we're gonna make. There's a house we could build. Every room inside is filled with things from far away. Special things I can pile, each one there to make you smile on a rainy day. They could say it all sounds crazy. They could say I've lost my mind. I don't care if they call us crazy. We could live in a world that we design. A million dreams is all it's gonna take.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And we're back with Charlie Stover and Harper Griffith. Hello, you guys.
Hi.
I love that duet that you just sang. It's one of my favorite
Thank
songs.
You. Thanks.
And I really wanted you to sing that on this show, so mm-hmm. I'm glad we have that. So Harper, let's turn to you. You are a young artist in my studio, Shannon Rae Vocal Studio.
Yes, I am.
And I could talk with you for days. We enjoy being together, don't we?
Oh, yeah.
You are the little sister of Sloane, who we'll meet later, so that's another set of siblings that we have. And you have been a regular on the Artist Showcase, so I'm really excited to catch up with you because there's a lot that's happened in this past year. So let's catch up right now. We have prepared quite a few self-tapes for you for auditions, and that led, if we look at the past year, that led to some commercials for one thing. So tell us about the commercials you've done.
In the past year, I've done Stair Slide. That was probably the funnest thing. I got to go up north and I got to go to this really, really fun house with these two other kids. And basically, I was the oldest one and I got my hair done and everything. And when they would videotape, you know, other people, we'd go downstairs and hang out or we would do something. And then when they would call us back up, we would change into our PJs because it was Christmas Eve. And we got to see a stair slide and we got to go down the stair slides. And it was really fun. It was also tiring too because we had to walk up the stairs and then go down and walk up the stairs and go down. But overall, it was a really, really fun time, and I really wanted one on my own. So the director just gave me 4 free ones with a cute little stair slide pad. So they're
fun.
Up on the stairs.
Yeah, and then really you did a laundry detergent commercial.
Yeah,
didn't
I did this cool little like 80s laundry commercial with like really cute things, and it was really fun. And I've worked with the director before because that was for my little toothbrush commercial that I did, and it was really fun. I got to meet new people, and it was in this old time like laundry store, and it was cool.
Oh, that was great. And then what about, just let's catch up really quick, you were on Yellowstone, and which part did you play during that series?
For the credits, they just called me Screaming Girl because, I mean, I saw my dad get shot, and I had to scream and cry, and it was my first ever TV show and commercial, not really commercial, but it's my first ever thing being on set, so I was already crying before because I was getting really nervous, and it was kind of easy for me because I was already crying.
Yep, that worked out great, didn't it? Good. And then what about your film work? You've just done an amazing project with Kevin Costner as well.
Yeah, I did A Horizon, and it was really, really fun. I did get to meet Kevin Costner, and I also got to meet this other guy, and he plays Vecna in Stranger Things.
Oh.
It was really cool, and you know, I got to get my hair done, and it was really fun. And I was basically a girl, they call me like Girl Intent One, who gets blown up. And yeah, I got it. There was scenes, and it was definitely scary. And we got blown up.
You've had some interesting experiences in film and television.
Definitely, yeah.
And you went to Moab, didn't you, to film that? So is that still in production? Do you know where that is right now?
They're making like, I think, 4 movies, and they're shooting the second one, I think, here. And they had a casting call, and I did go, but we did say that I was already in it. So, you know, we could have me as an extra, but I did get blown up, so I could also be a ghost. We were talking about that and stuff, but
that's fun.
We haven't gotten a call yet, so.
Okay. You are a regular performer at TuaCon. You've done 4 seasons, like I said, together. Could you tell us quickly about Wonderland, which was last year?
Yeah.
So this is second in 1 year, the second show.
Yeah.
So tell us about Wonderland and Charlie.
Wonderland was really, really fun. When I got the call that I was young Alice, I was like, I don't think I'm going to be needed that much. But then I realized that she's young Alice, and I looked at the script. Everyone was so nice to me. And I really like that about TuaCon because you're just going to meet people and bond with them and have good relationships with them. And some of the people from Alice in Wonderland, and that season are now in this season for Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. I am Candy Kid, so I'm just basically kids ensemble in that. Mm-hmm. We don't really get used a lot, but I'm okay with that because we get to hang out backstage and play cards and, you know, really hang out with each other. So that, it's been really fun, and we still get to do a lot of dancing, which is really nice too.
I thought you were such a good dancer. Like I said, I've seen the show already, and you really stood out. Because I think you're the youngest, aren't you, of all the dancers?
I'm the second youngest, yeah.
Yeah, you did great. I'm so proud of you. And then you're in Finding Nemo right now.
Yes, I am. I am actually Nemo in Finding Nemo Jr. I do have a rehearsal after this.
Oh, right after this.
Yeah, right after this. So I am so excited because I get to ride on my little Heelys, and it's really, really fun, and it's the best because it's just all about, the director wanted it to be about, you know, showing people kindness. So he has, every twice a week, he has people come in with disabilities and talk about it. And it really helps us understand how to treat people the right way with disabilities. Mm. And in the show, there are different people with disabilities that he wanted. So it's definitely there. Like Nemo has a bad fin. So I have to have my arm down for the whole entire show, so I only have one arm. But overall, it's just really fun.
I'm excited to see that. That's a collaboration between Encore and St. George Musical Theater.
Yes.
And I think it's the first premiere here in Southern Utah of Finding
Nemo
Jr.
Yeah.
Okay, so what's coming up next for you?
I actually got a callback for any tour. I am so excited. I'm actually leaving tonight. So I'm gonna have to miss Charlie, which I'm very bummed about because someone from the kids cast is going on for a person for Mike TV, and I don't get to see that. So, but I do have people's phone numbers, so, you know, it's really fun. And I'm honestly overjoyed when I got the call. Well, my mom got an email, and I was actually in Finding Nemo rehearsal, and I came out after it was done, and she was talking to my agent on the phone, and I was like, oh, this is probably just for something. And she hangs up the phone, and she says that you got a email for to be on the Annie tour. You got a call back, and we're leaving next week, so you're gonna have to be packing, and we have to get flights, and I think it's gonna be really exciting.
And where are you going for that? This is the most
exciting part. I'm going to New York City, New York City today. And I'm so excited because the last time I went to New York City, it was so much fun. I got to see Broadway shows, and I'm just so excited to go.
That's a really big deal. Back in New York City for Annie. Amazing. What are you singing for us tonight?
I'm going to be singing the Girl Scout song from Beetlejuice. Not many people have heard of it. And then I am singing Million Dreams with Charlie, like he said. And then I'm just singing a tiny bit in my sister's song, Morning Person. Just a tiny bit. I'm just a bird.
Yeah. But it's really cute.
Yeah.
Okay. We're so happy you're both here with us. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
You can head over to Instagram and find Harper at Harper Lily Griffith. You'll see her perform right here coming up next.
Hi, my name is Harper Griffith, and I'll be singing the Girl Scout song from Beetlejuice.
This is it, the day I've been waiting for, wishing, hoping, working, and praying for the day my parents have been delaying for years. Ooh, I'm gonna sell some cookies. Not their fault that they're overprotective. I was born with arrhythmia. My heart is defective. Only take one shock, and I could be dead from the fear. Still, I'm gonna sell some cookies. Hike by hike, song by song, the Girl Scouts helped my heart grow strong. They'd had my back then. distracted from the fact that my heart could stop from the challenge I fell into my pulmonary arteries. Whee! When you're a Girl Scout, everything's gonna work out. Even when you're born with congenital heart disease and you could be killed by a random sneeze, you're a Girl Scout, and everything's gonna work out. Just gonna ring the bell of this creepy looking house.
Hello, little girl.
Support the Girl Scouts by selling cookies. $4 a box, would you like some?
Sure.
Really?
Yeah, what flavors you got?
Well, I've got chocolate, banana, and oat bran, pecan, s'mores, and thin mints, and one that tastes like apple pie.
Why don't you come inside?
But we're really not supposed to.
Why?
Pedophiles. But it's so cold, and you're not mean, and no one gets molested by gothy teens, so I guess okay, it's fine.
Yeah?
All right, I'll come inside. It's so dark in here.
Is it? I hadn't noticed.
Okay, well, maybe I should come back another time when your parents are home?
Boo!
Sloane!
Experience active learning and career readiness at Utah Tech University. Formerly Dixie State University, Utah Tech has risen from the desert as one of the fastest growing, most affordable, safest, and rapidly evolving universities in the nation. Our polytechnic mission creates hands-on learning opportunities for all of our 200-plus programs. So join us and experience the difference at Utah Tech University.
Welcome back, everyone. I'd like to welcome Lily Mae Stover and Sloane Griffith to our show. It's so nice to have you here.
Yeah,
great to see you.
Thanks for having us.
You have been on the show before, and so this is old hat for you. But you've grown so much in the past year. It's amazing. I think it's been about a year. Yeah. So, Sloane, you are the big sister to Harper,
yes,
who we just heard from. And Lily Mae, you're the big sister to Charlie. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So tell us how old you both are.
I'm 17.
I'm 15. I turned 16 in like the end of the month.
End of June.
Yeah.
Oh, mm-hmm. Yeah. You girls have grown up so much. So you have performed together for years, starting back. Well, I know you both started really, really young singing, but I think the first performance together was when you were 7.
Probably.
Right? Well, around there. Tell us about that. It's such a fun story.
Oh, 4th of July.
Yes. Yeah.
We did a duet to, what's it, Put on a Happy,
Put on a Happy Face from Bye Bye Birdie.
Uh-huh. We performed it at the like local 4th of July competition that they do, and we got second place.
Yeah,
it was like St. George's Got Talent.
Yeah.
Yes, voice competition, they still do it on the 4th of July.
Yeah.
And you won second place to Jaden Webster,
who
is another artist from the Artist Showcase. Yeah. And you won money.
Yeah, we got a little money.
And a little trophy?
Yes.
I've seen a picture.
Giant,
inserted picture of that.
Giant check.
Yes.
Yeah.
And when we were so small, it looked so big compared
to
us.
Yeah, especially the trophy we were holding.
So that was the beginning of your stardom. That's so fun that you performed together. Okay, so Lily Mae, let's talk to you for a minute. You've performed a lot of shows, a lot of local theater, local shows, community theater, and TuaCon. And I researched, and you've done 9 TuaCon shows and 30 local theater shows. So, what's the most memorable? What are the most memorable roles that you've played?
Oh, gosh. At TuaCon, my favorite show that I did at TuaCon was Matilda. That was in 2018. And it was, like, the first show I can really remember doing at TuaCon, because the other season I did was, like, a while back. I think I was, like, 6. 6, like, and 7, both. But, so, Matilda is the first one I really remember, and it's the most memorable. I think we just got really lucky with, like, Sloane was in it with me, and we had, like, the best kids cast, and, like, it was just such a good experience, because it was really, like, the first, regional show I can remember doing, and everyone was just so sweet, and the show itself was just so fun because it was a heavily like kid involved show, mm-hmm. and it was fun. I played Amanda Thripp, so I got to fly on the little on the Foy flight system, and that was super cool.
Good. Any other roles that you've loved?
Yeah, I've done Les Mis twice. Both times I played Cosette, and the most recent time I did it at my school, Utah Arts Academy, which was really fun because it was the first musical I did in high school, and it was awesome. It was a really good experience. It was last November, December, I think.
I don't want to forget to mention, I've loved working with both of you the last couple of years in various capacities, but we have to mention my colleague and one of my dearest friends, Rachel Cox. Mm-hmm. She has been your vocal teacher for mm-hmm. years, yeah. since you were quite young.
Yeah, I love Rachel. She's awesome.
So you've had excellent training, and mm-hmm. that shows in everything that you do. So you mentioned Utah Arts Academy, mm-hmm. and you are you just finished your junior year?
I just finished my sophomore year.
So you'll be a junior.
Yeah.
What do you love about Utah Arts Academy?
It's just a really good environment, and there are so many interests that I have, like regarding the arts, that I can be so heavily involved in like different things. Mm-hmm. Like last year, I was able to take like so many different classes. I was able to take like visual arts, acting, and this year, hopefully the schedule hasn't come out yet, but I got into guitar ensemble and improv company and Shakespeare company, and those three I'm like so excited for, and they're all kind of a little different. Improv I did last year as well, and that was probably one of my favorite parts about Utah Arts because it's just so fun, and it's something that like I hadn't really done before, and it was just a really good experience.
Yeah, mm-hmm. so much creativity going on
yeah,
there.
Yeah, and the school is just such a good environment. The teachers are amazing, and the kids are awesome. It's just really cool.
Yeah, and you're also looking to be a singer-songwriter, mm-hmm. and I know that that's a path you can take there as well.
Yeah, I'm going to take a singer-songwriter class this year, too, and there's a competition called Young Arts, and I'm going to do the singer-songwriter category for Young Arts as
I'm
well.
I'm so glad mm-hmm. you're doing that.
Yeah,
that
I'm super
so
excited.
Good. Okay, so you and Charlie have agents in LA mm-hmm. for film and television.
Yeah.
And we mentioned that you were in This Bloody Country with him. Tell mm-hmm. us about that experience for you.
It was a really good experience. So originally I auditioned for This Bloody Country, Charlie and I auditioned for like the lead daughter role, and Charlie auditioned for like the son role. It's like a big family. And I didn't get the role, so I was like, oh man, but Charlie left and did it. So he was filming, and I was just here going to school and stuff, until randomly one day, the actor who was playing a certain role, I don't think she could show up. I think she was sick or something. So they just called me in because I guess they remembered my audition, and I looked similar. It was also a flashback scene, and I looked similar to the girl who was playing the role, the adult. So they were like, perfect, just Charlie's older sister. So aww. I got to go in for a day and film it, which was so cool. It was like a small scene, but it was nice to be featured in the show.
Yeah. So you've had some training in Cincinnati.
Mm-hmm,
and
yeah.
that was the last summer, I think. I remember us talking mm-hmm. about that. So what did you do there? What were you getting trained for?
Last summer I auditioned for a few like college programs. They're like pre-college intensives over the summer, and I got accepted into the CCM one, and the group that I was in, there were 12 of us, and it was so awesome. It was a week, and we just took a bunch of dance classes, a bunch of like college prep, like getting your book ready, acting out the song classes, and it was so cool. I just got to get close to the group of people, and it was a really awesome experience.
And you got to work on CCM, which we've worked on together.
Yes.
Which you hadn't done a lot, and mm-hmm. so I'm sure that was really fun.
Yeah, it was really cool. Mm-hmm.
Yes. And you're going to be you're performing on Bale Street, aren't you?
Yeah, uh-huh.
Yeah.
This July, I will be going up to Bale Street, and I'll be performing.
Yes. Yeah. That's going to be so exciting. I was mm-hmm. telling your mom I wish I could be there.
Yeah, I'm so excited. It's kind of like we've been wanting to do this for a while, but we didn't like make it like a decision up until like a few weeks ago. So now I'm just super excited to go.
And then there's one other thing that you're doing this summer, mm-hmm. which I'm very excited yes. for. Tell us where you're going to get some more training.
So I did last summer. I went to CCM for the pre-college program, and this year I had such a good experience last summer that I was like, I need to audition for a bunch more. So I auditioned for so many more, and I decided to choose to go to OCU because yes. I'm so excited. It's just such a good program, and they have like classical training as well, which is something that I'm interested in. So I'm excited to be able to work on like musical theater and classical there for 2 weeks.
It doesn't get any better because yeah, I went
because
there.
Because you went there.
And that's where I met Kristen Chenoweth yes. and we sang together. Mm-hmm. So when I heard you were going there, I was so excited for you. Yeah. You're even staying in Walker Hall where I live.
Yeah, exactly. That's
amazing.
So crazy.
So how can we follow you, first of all?
My Instagram is just Lily Mae Stover, LillyMaeStover.
Great. And what are you singing for us tonight?
I'm going to be singing On the Steps of the Palace from Into the Woods, and then I'm going to be doing a duet with Sloan, and we're going to be singing For Good from Wicked.
Can't wait.
Yep.
It's going to be so good. Lily Mae will be taking the stage next, so stay right here.
Beware the temptation of those less devout than we. Corpus Christi.
Amen!
Sanguis Christi. Well, remember, we are all born sinners.
Morning in Paris, the city awakes to the bells of Notre Dame.
Long years ago did this story begin
me?
In this place
the walls?
Called
the oh!
Notre Dame.
Amongst this child is my cross to bear.
Beata Maria.
No!
Oh, I am a righteous man.
Self-control, Quasimodo.
My virtue, I am justly proud.
Look at them down there. Beata like horrible Maria. Vermin scuttling about.
You know I'm so much purer than the common vulgar, weak, licentious crowd.
I'm Captain Phoebus de Martin. I've been working hard. Now I'm gonna be captain of the guard. Ain't that a notion?
The pestilence of these gypsies grows more dangerous every day.
Give me one day out there. All I ask is one to hold forever.
We asked for the ugliest face in Paris.
I won't care. I'll have space.
I am warning you about this girl. She is dangerous.
God help the outcast, hungry from birth.
Thank you. She was nice to me.
Was she? And what do you know about people and their feelings, my boy? I should have known. No gypsy would ever want to be saved.
I don't think I'm in need of saving.
Everything talks to me, my friend.
Sing for
we have so little time left to say goodbye. You came back!
I need your help.
Anything!
There is a gypsy witch endangering our citizens with her sorcery.
She must be stopped.
Are you disobeying a direct order?
I'm Lily Mae Stover, and I'm going to be singing On the Steps of the Palace from Into the Woods. He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him, he spread pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares, and I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? You think, make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, it's a thought, what would be his response? But then what if he knew who you were when you know that you're not what he thinks that he wants? And then what if you are what a prince would envision? Although how can you know who you are till you know what you want, what you don't? So then which do you pick, where you're safe out of sight and yourself, but where everything's wrong? everything's right and you know that you'll never belong. And whichever you pick, do it quick, 'cause you're starting to stick to the steps of the palace. It's your first big decision. The choice isn't easy to make. To arrive at a ball is exciting, and know once you're there, though it's scary. And it's fun to deceive when you know you can leave, but you have to be wary. There's a lot that's at stake, but you've stalled long enough, 'cause you're still standing stuck to the stuff on the steps. Better run along home and avoid the collision. Even though they don't care, you'll be better off there, where there's nothing to choose, so there's nothing to lose. So you pry up your shoes. Then from out of the blue, and without any guide, you know what your decision is, which is not to decide. You'll just leave him a clue, for example, a shoe, and then see what he'll do. Now it's he and not you who is stuck with a shoe in a stew, in the goo. And you've learned something too, something you never knew. On the steps of the palace! Thank you.
And we're back with our final artist of the Fabulous Four tonight, Sloane Griffith.
Hi.
I've been excited to talk with you. You are the big sister of Lily Mae. I mean, sorry, Lily Mae is here. You're the big sister of Harper.
Yes.
And you and Harper have a manager that you share and two agents, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And has that been a big help to you?
Yeah, honestly, we get so much help from them. They are so helpful in sending us auditions, and also they look at them and make sure we're on the right track and everything looks good. And yeah, they've been super helpful. They've helped Harper and I book.
So. Good, that's great. And this is your, how many seasons have you been at 2 O'Con?
This is my sixth season.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
So which major roles have you played, and what are the most memorable to you?
Probably my most memorable show, definitely Matilda. That, I don't know,
just
everyone you ask about
show.
It, it's always their favorite.
Yes.
It was so fun. We got so close with all of the kids. A lot of them were actually from out of town. And we're all still so close. It's crazy. A lot of us talk very often.
2 O'Con is like one big happy family.
Yeah.
I think that there are lots of people that keep coming back to perform.
Yeah.
And it just seems really like a close-knit group.
It is.
Anyway, okay, so last summer you were Katie in School of
Rock.
Yeah, uh-huh.
That was really cool.
One of my favorite shows there.
I played the bass on stage live every night, which was really cool. I've never been in a band before. I've sang to a band, but I obviously haven't played an instrument. So that was really cool, practicing with them and having to wear an earpiece so you get the metronome, and it was just a really cool experience.
Yes.
Nothing I've ever done, so yeah, it was fun.
And what other roles have you played?
I've mostly done just kid ensemble in a lot of them, and then last year I was I'm kind of too old to be in the kid ensemble, so maybe I'll just try out for Good Experience for the adult ensemble, and then I ended up actually getting in, which it's been really fun. It was really fun last year, and I originally was only in Mary Poppins and Joseph, but then one of the ladies dropped out, so they were like, will you be in Wonderland? And I was like, okay, sure. So I had to learn that in a couple weeks, and I got to do that. So I finished out the season doing all three shows, so it was really fun.
Well, you're a really good dancer.
Well,
you're a great singer, too. But I mean, I can see how they're using you in so many different ways, many different roles.
It's so fun.
That is fun. I remember, too, hearing that you were going to be in the adult cast. That was a really big deal.
Yeah, it was just,
for the first
time. I guess it was surprising because I was just going to audition for experience, because it's different auditioning as a kid and auditioning as an adult. The combos are harder and you have to go in with your own material. So it's just kind of a different experience and it's more like the real world, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's preparing you well. And then what about this season? You've got a lot going on.
Yeah. So this season I'm in the adult ensemble again of Charlie and Hunchback. And then I swing Tarzan, which is
just a big, good challenge. Uh-huh. Yeah, it's fun. I cover 5 roles is like my first cover. So if any of those 5 people are out, I'm on. And then I second cover 4 roles. So in total, I cover about 9 roles. And then all the swings kind of dip into like, if they're a guy, then they learn some of the girl stuff. And so I learned some of the guy stuff just for fun, you know, mm-hmm. I have some time. So you never know what could happen with, you know, sickness and everything.
Yeah,
but
that's true. A lot happened last season, so we know that.
Yes, last season was a lot, but
yes.
Yeah, it's been a good challenge, and I have like this iPad which just has like pages and pages of notes and drawings because it's just, you know, it's a lot. But
I don't know how you did. That's really impressive.
It's fun.
Incredible. Congratulations on graduating
with
your associate's degree.
Yeah, yeah.
And so what are your plans now? You have the summer, you're doing all these shows, and then what are you doing?
Yeah, so after this summer, I'm starting online at the University of Utah. I'm majoring in marketing and minoring in dance. So I'm excited. I'm starting online, though, so I can finish out the contract. And then in January, I'll move up there and I'll finish out the year in person. And so I have about like 2 or so years left so I can finish my bachelor's. And yeah, I'm excited. And we'll see after that. I'm going to keep auditioning for tours and stuff, you know, you never know. But yeah.
And you're hoping to audition at Hale Center Theater?
Yeah, yeah. While I'm living up there, I would love to work at Hale or Pioneer. They're all really great theaters. And you know, more experience, so it'd be fun.
I'm glad to hear that you're going to continue.
Yeah.
So how can we follow you, and what are you singing tonight?
You can follow me at sloan.griffith. I'm pretty sure that's what my username is everywhere. And I'm singing Morning Person from Shrek, and then, like Lily said, we have our duet, so.
I can't wait. We'll meet you girls over at your Instagram and Facebook. And Sloan will be our final performer of the night, so stay tuned. We're back here after this.
Tarzan. Jane.
Tarzan.
What are you, some sort of a wild man?
Jane.
Exactly.
I wanna know. Can you show me? I wanna know about these strangers like me. Tell me more. Please show me something's familiar about.
Well, that's extraordinary too, isn't it?
In learning, you will take.
Can't keep it.
And in teaching, you will learn.
Tarzan!
You'll find your
keep
place.
Teach
the ones you love.
We'll live away from the tribe.
For how long?
For as long as he needs me.
You'll be in my heart. Yes, you'll be in my heart.
Mom!
From this day on, now and forth.
You made it all the way into the trees? I am so proud of you!
I'm gonna be the best ape ever!
Mom?
Hello?
Thanks. This hatching business seems to be nearly a full-time act.
2 worlds, 1 family. Trust your heart, let fate decide to guide these lives. To guide these lives, we see.
Hi, my name is Sloan Griffith, and I will be singing A Morning Person from Shrek the Musical.
The sun's so big, it hurts my eyes. But really, that's
okay. A brand new day with things to do. So many plans to make. I've had 6 cups of coffee, so I'm really wide awake. I've always been a morning person, a morning girl. Hooray!
Cheep, 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 cheep.
Hooray!
Cheep, 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 cheep.
Hooray!
Cheep, 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 cheep.
Good morning, dear, say, have you heard? Today's my wedding day. I haven't met my husband yet, but I'm hopeful anyway. I'll wear a gown, we'll have a ball, and dance forevermore. He'll take me in his massive arms and spin me. Fresh as lime sorbet. Last night I was a monster, but this morning, I'm okay. This morning, I'm okay.
Thank you. Now I'm going to invite Lily Mae up on the stage, and we're going to be singing For Good from Wicked.
I've heard it said that people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes the sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the woods. Who can say if I've been changed for the better, but because I knew you, I have been changed for good.
It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. So let me say before we part, so much of me is made of what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a seed dropped by a sky bird in a distant wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better, but because I knew you.
Because I knew you,
I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air. I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blamed me for. But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes the sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway in the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? I do believe I have been changed for the better. Because I knew you. Because I knew you. Because I knew you.
I'd like to thank our sponsors for tonight's show, Interiors Inc., our favorite cookie shop, The Sugar Cookie, as well as Alan Holben Photography, Kensington Owens for sound engineering, our production crew here at CEC-TV, and tonight's featured artists, siblings Charlie and Lily Mae Stover, and sisters Harper and Sloan Griffith. Thank you for watching and for being a part of our show tonight. You can follow us on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook for updates. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll meet you back here for another episode of the Artist Showcase.